So, welcome guys and girls. Let us see what happens to India and Indians. Suppose if there is no rain and there is no crop for 1 year. Very bad indeed. Suppose if there is no crop and no rain for 2 years, what happens? For consecutive 2 years. What happens to 125 crores of population? Are you worried? Really, don't you be worried. India can feed its citizens even if there is no crop for a year or two by withdrawing the food grain from the godowns of Food Corporation of India. In fact, the India government can support Indians, all 125 crores, for 7 years even if there is no crop or grain, because we have buffer stocks. You know what is a buffer? From buffer stocks, government of India will withdraw the grain and distribute it to the needy. And again, whatever that it has withdrawn, it will try to import and fill it if the, in case of there is no crop. Like that, they maintain the stock, food stock. And if there is excess of crop, they withdraw some amount of old grain and distribute it to the needy or to help people of other countries and replace it with new grain. Like that, a buffer is a cushion. So also, you can have buffer solutions. In pure water, suppose if you add a drop of acid, its acidic nature drastically increases. pH drops down from 7 to less than 4. A 1,000 times increase in H+ ion concentration for a drop of acid in 1 liter of water. However, our human blood has a pH of 7.36 to 7.45. Even if two ants or three ants bite, we don't die, because this is a buffer system. In a buffer system, addition of a little acid or base would not alter the pH greatly. Now here is a problem based on the buffer system, and we have seen earlier a buffer pH is given by, if it is an acidic buffer, pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt by acid concentration. This is called Henderson equation. Similarly, the pOH of a basic buffer is given by pKb plus log of salt by base concentration. Let us see a problem now. Look at this problem, and this problem is like this. A solution of 0.1 normal ammonium hydroxide, a weak base, and 0.1 normal ammonium chloride has a pH of 9.25. pKb of ammonium hydroxide is how much? Now this problem is giving 4 options, of course. How to solve this problem? To solve this problem, let us say, to solve this problem, we invoke the Henderson equation. pOH is equal to pKb plus log of salt by base. Now they have given pH. So pOH is equal to 14 minus pH. 14 minus pH is called, 14 minus pH is nothing but pOH. pOH is equal to pKb, I don't know, plus log of concentration of salt by concentration of base. The value of this is given as 9.25. 14 minus. Now this is equal to 4.75 is equal to pKb, because log of 0.1 by 0.1 is log 1, log 1 is 0. Therefore, the pKb of the given solution is 4.75. Notice that this is a particular formula to find pOH of a basic buffer, and for pH of a similar acidic buffer is given by pKa plus log of salt by acid concentration. Notice that this is called Henderson equation. You need to see that the ratio between salt to acid can greatly influence the pH. If both are equal, pH is equal to pKa, then it have highest buffer capacity. Thank you.